here is our driver's side rear swing arm that I boxed in. Welded all the seams. Our ball joint's still good, so we don't have to worry about replacing that. But before we can put it together, we have to take all this freaking tape off. Good part about this is it's not dirty anymore. We're not gonna get dirty hands, greasy, nasty, dirty, fucked up hands. So I'm just gonna orient this in the direction that it goes, which is like this. And then this is our rear knuckle. Slides up. Probably be easier to do it upside down. Has a nylon shush nut on it. It doesn't appear to be the right one. That got it. Okay, no damage so far. The next thing I want to put on is this. But I gotta loosen these up just a smidge. Okay. dumbass. Oh no, that's right. Okay. So I loosened these two to get a little bit of movement in there, but that way when I put this thing back together, when I got it, that this tie rod in was tweaked up like this. I want it flush and flat. It'll be okay. And then the next thing we can put on is our axle. Let me clean it for a minute. When I need that O-ring. This thing has a dust seal that goes on like so. And it's going to ride up against the back. So I'm going to put a little grease around it. Next time we have to take it off, and then you're just gonna slide in. And then we got a big washer. Thank you. far as torque goes, you want that really tight. Nut will lock down in, and we're pretty much back where we were when we started, so all is well. This is a screwdriver specifically modified for that. So now we can see if our rotor is gonna fit. And it does. And then we can put on our spacer after we line the holes up like that. Then we can put on our brake. Caliper holder. Oh, we gotta put the clips in. Weighed the new struts, they're about 13.5 pounds, so same as the old one, a little bit lighter than the other old one that was a little bit heavier than the other old one. I'm gonna put these clips in, and they're just springs, so you gotta kind of compress them a little bit, get them in there, twist them, drop them. Okay, so now we can get this whole thing over to the car and put it in. Again, this is not final assembly. I'm just throwing it on there so I can move the car, but the process is the same, and I'm going to include it all in this same video. If we were doing it for the final time, we'd have to put the spacers in there, crank everything down, but we're just gonna run it loose so I can drop the car and move it. So the good part is, it's all clean and I'm not getting my hands dirty anymore, right? This is nice. I like it. Touch everything. I know I said it's not final assembly, but from the dollar store. We can keep the fingerprints to a minimum. So next, is our new coil, adjustable coilover. So it's gonna fit on right here and then go up into the perch. I'm gonna try doing the perch first. God. 13.5 pounds is kinda heavy. Washer went, because I didn't. Here it is. So what we have to do is pick up our knuckle, stick it in here, and get our bolt started. So we're reusing the original on the bottom, and then on the top we use this adjustable one. So shouldn't be too hard, but it's a Fiat. So you want to make sure that these two washers are facing the same direction, because that's where your adjustability comes from. So now, if I had another 17, I could tighten this up. Marshall said torque specs are like 55 and 45 or something like that. So we tightened everything up on this side. I'm gonna need parking brakes to stop the car. So I gotta put brake calipers. So I have to put the brake pads and brake caliper back on. not correct? That's not correct. Go build the other side, put it together, put it on. I'm gonna throw wheels on it. I'm gonna lower it to the ground, tighten up those top nuts on the struts. Well, take that back. I'm gonna put the sway bar on, then I'll lower it. I'll bring you back when we install sway bar. Okay, I brought you back. So I got the other side together and hung. And now it's time to put sway bar on.
Thank you. again, this is just mocked up because suspension's coming off when I put the motor in, so I can get it in there. I think I can leave the sway bar on and just tilt it down and it won't be in my way. I think. Yes, I will put that washer in when it's time. But I like it. So the only thing left is put the tires on, drop it down, push it outside, flip it around, bring it in, do the entire front end, do the radiator. Well, and I gotta clean the underside and treat for rust and repaint it and all that other stuff. But, you know, I can do all of that with a motor in the car if I have to. Couldn't do all of this with motor in the car. I think that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Y'all have a good day.